The next question, the member for London West.
Speaker, my question is to the Premier. Last week, the Middlesex-London Health Unit wrote to this government urging an increase to social assistance rates. Their letter states, and I quote, "Middlesex-London residents with low incomes cannot afford to eat after meeting other essential needs." Speaker, at a time of unprecedented inflation, food insecurity in our province is higher than ever before. Our health unit is telling this government that people on ODSP and Ontario Works are not eating. Speaker, why is this government keeping social assistance rates so low that those who rely on social assistance are forced to go without food?
Mr. Children, Community and Social Services.
Thanks very much, Speaker, and I thank my honourable colleague for the question. Mr. Speaker, it's been this government that has been there for every single Ontarian when we said we're not going to leave them behind. Mr. Speaker, I would just remind a member, Mr. Speaker, of all the decisions that they have voted against, Mr. Speaker. First of all, the largest increase to support the most vulnerable here in the province, Mr.
Order.
Speaker. What did the opposition do?
Order.
They voted against it.
Shame.
Then, Mr. Speaker, the rates were aligned to inflation, which was the right thing to do to provide more support for Ontarians at a time of high costs and everything as a result
Order.
Of a carbon tax that they supported that we are against, Mr. Speaker. Time and time and time again, it's this government that's fighting for Ontarians. The NDP will say one thing, Mr. Speaker, when the lights are on and the camera's rolling, and then when it comes to actually voting and
Order.
Supporting Ontarians, they'll continue to turn their back on them. Just like they failed to support the Liberals in 15 years, Mr. Speaker, we said from the beginning.
Thank you. Order. A supplementary question.
Thank you, Speaker. Again to the Premier. Food banks in London and across Ontario are stretched to the limit. In just the last year, the London Food Bank saw a 40% increase in demand. The emergency food cupboard at the Northwest London Resource Centre in my riding is seeing five or six new families a day. When people can't afford food, Speaker, their physical and mental health suffers. It causes more chronic conditions, more non-communicable diseases, more infections, depression, anxiety, and stress. Speaker, will this government listen to the Middlesex Health Unit, lift people on social assistance out of legislated poverty, and increase social assistance rates?
Members, please take their seats. Minister of Children, Community and Social Services.
$1.2 billion towards helping communities through the Social Services Relief Fund, Mr. Speaker. $1.2 billion to help with food, for help with cost of housing, Mr. Speaker. Investing $83 million through the Ontario Trillium Foundation to support, Mr. Speaker, nonprofit organizations, including food banks. $8 million in support for funding Feed Ontario. Mr. Speaker, every single measure that we've taken to help Ontarians during the cost of high
Order.
Prices everywhere, Mr. Speaker, the NDP continuously votes against. They will never support
Opposition
lowering costs in this province, Mr. Speaker. You've seen them. You've heard them. They'll say one thing here in the House, but as soon as it comes to actions, Mr. Speaker, they're MIA. They don't exist. It's this Premier and it's this government that says we'll make sure that every single Ontarian supported and no one is left behind, and we'll put our